Ready. Start. Madam, Vice Chairman, yesterday the Honorable Minister made a very strong case for his resolution. He stressed the necessity for an integrated approach to these problems. He appealed in the name of national integration to accept this proposal. He also stressed the necessity of having emotional integration through this measure. Well, I am not against having an integrated approach. As far as both education and agriculture are concerned, but my fear is whether this step in the present context will at all help the integrated approach which he wants and the national integration which he is aspiring for. Now I will concentrate more on the educational service. I was thinking about this problem after I heard the Honorable Minister yesterday with my state in my mind. Our state is considered to be one of those which are so far ahead in education. But unfortunately, the situation there is not very happy. Coming to college education, in our state, there are a large number of private colleges. There are a number of government colleges, and there are a few colleges directly under the university. Now, those college teachers who are directly under the university are considered to be the blessed few because they have a higher salary, fewer hours of work, and sometimes the number of students whom they have to teach happens to be very limited, whereas teachers with the same qualification employed in government colleges have to work 18 hours or even more, and they get a meager salary. The creation of these university teachers instead of helping to integrate is causing so much of discontent among the government college teachers. Now, this creation of an All India Education Service will create another few persons who may be much better placed than either the university teachers or the government college teachers. This state of affairs, I am afraid, will create more confusion rather than help integration. Now, as I mentioned earlier, there is a third category of private college teachers. Their condition is not very much better than that of high school teachers. In some cases, their condition is worse. The pay they used to get was so low that whenever they got a better chance elsewhere, they used to leave these colleges and go. The result of this state of affairs on the education in the colleges is that their standards are very low throughout the whole country. So, when I think of the integration of education in my state, leaving aside the other parts of India, I feel much more than introducing this All India service. Some other things have to be done in our state to remove this anomaly, and I feel that as far as college education is concerned, whether it be in the private sector or in the public sector, wherever it is, the government have to take the responsibility for college education. the pay and other things have to be almost similar as far as these private colleges, government colleges and the university colleges are concerned. Unless that is done, you will not be able to integrate the educational system inside our state itself. In the final analysis, the result of the present state of affairs falls on the standard of the students. At one time, the colleges in the South, especially Tamil Nadu and Kerala, boasted themselves of having a higher standard compared to the colleges elsewhere. Now, the position is entirely different. I am not speaking about Tamil Nadu. As far as my state is concerned, the standard has fallen very low and the students coming from our colleges find it very difficult to get admission in other places. Secondly, speaking about technical education, our state, though rather high as far as literacy is concerned, in the matter of technical education is lagging far behind. A few institutions in the private sector, engineering colleges and medical colleges are now permitted. But there also, because of so many factors, the standards are very low and the government have to do something by which at least the technical education is immediately taken over by the government. So, to have an engineering college without the necessary appliances to teach is not only harmful to the students, but it is harmful to the state itself. So also, regarding the medical colleges, these are the things on which I would like the government to pay primary attention, and then we can think of the All India services, etc. There is another anomaly. The students passing from our high schools cannot get admission in the colleges outside our state because the entire system is different. Last year, there was a lot of difficulty. Nearly 2,000 students expected admission in the Mysore University. Finally, when they found that it was difficult because of the difference in the syllabus and all that, so some uniformity has to be brought in. That can be done only by making education a concurrent subject. The government should take all necessary steps to see that you have a uniform system of education. Stop.